Thank you, Amherst Media, for your continued support of Amherst Town Government. I'm Lynn Griesmer, and I have served since December of 2018 as your District 2 counselor, along with Pat DeAngelis, and I have served as president of the council during that entire time. The past 5 years have been a major transition for our community, and I've worked to help our new government succeed from the beginning, from the not-so-glamorous tasks to the much more difficult and long-term challenges. Our progress on some of the capital projects is nothing short of astonishing. We will open a new elementary school on Fort River site in 2026, and the library, both renovation and addition, is moving forward with additional state dollars, federal dollars, and the contributions of many donors. We need to finish the job by building a fire station, south fire and EMS station, south of downtown, and we need to build a new DPW. But those are in the works. I have added two other capital projects to my list. The first is reviving and renewing our senior center, including with a brand new kitchen that we will pay for with COVID funds. The second is developing a multi-year plan to improve and replace our deteriorating roads and sidewalks in a manner that allows our community not feel like we live in a rural, third world dirt road country. Renewing our physical assets also gives us an opportunity to continue and strengthen our obligation to sustainability. We work with the town's net zero energy bylaw, and we can see it in our new buildings as they happen. And in addition to that, I'm now working on focusing on getting our first ever solar energy bylaw. George Floyd's murder revealed ongoing inequities in our society. And we've started to address those with the creation of the Diversity, Equity, and Inclusion Department, the CREST Department, and developing a path forward for a police oversight board. The hallmark of our community is our small town character that relies on strong neighborhoods, affordable housing, and efficient, high quality services. We need to make sure we do this, but not in the burden of residential taxes. And that means developing vibrant downtown and village centers and the additional success in broadening housing opportunities. I was reared by my parents, who had very steeped in civic responsibilities. When they passed when I was 18, I also began raising my younger sisters. And the power of obligation that we each felt to each other hit home as I went to college, worked, and raised the girls with the help of family, friends, and Social Security. For the past 15 years, I've been privileged to work with the Amherst Survival Center. I took the lead on the capital campaign for our wonderful new building along with three other people and served as president of the board. I've also been active in the Girl Scouts of Western Mass, Central and Western Mass, chairing their audit committee, and I recently joined the Women's Fund of Western Mass. My professional life has been a terrific journey. I started as a math teacher in rural Appalachia, making it an indelible impression on me about the process of public education and our obligation to bring out the best in every child. It also included working with the UMass Donahue Institute, where I worked with dislocated workers, and over time became executive director and vice president for economic development, working in STEM, Head Start, economic analysis, and with new legislators. I'm very proud of the council's accomplishments, but I also have experienced some concern. I reject the corrosion that is eating away at public confidence everywhere. Amherst should be an example of how good government works even when we disagree. That remains my highest priority. Thanks for listening, and please support our town moving forward.